In this video, I am going to discuss about constructivism, learning theories and its classroom implications. Constructivism learning theory goes beyond the conception of the learners as neutral information processor to consider what actually data himself contribute as an active participant. The learner is seen as a very active participant and his experience and the background will influence the way new knowledge takes hold. This constructivism grounded in the research works of Piaget and Vygotsky. Both theories agree on the central ideas. Learners are active in constructing their own knowledge and social interaction are important in this knowledge construction process. Learning takes place when the learner combining prior knowledge and experience with the information being offered. Takes full ownership by newly constructing the learning in his own brain. A teacher leading an exploratory discussion of a poem or a story is applying constructive theory. This theory is closely related to the works of Jean Piaget and Samuel Papert also. There are few underlying assumptions given by Johnson to know the constructive learning environment and is applicable to both the perspectives. Constructive learning environments provide multiple representations of reality. Multiple representations avoid oversimplification and represent the complexity of the real world. Constructive learning environments emphasize knowledge construction instead of knowledge reproduction. Constructive learning environment emphasizes authentic tasks in a meaningful context rather than abstract instruction out of context. Constructive learning environment provide learning environments such as real-world settings or case-based learning instead of predetermined sequence of instruction. Constructivist learning environment encourage thoughtful reflection on experience. Constructivist learning environment enable context and context-dependent knowledge construction. Constructivist learning environment support collaborative construction of knowledge through social negotiation, not competition among the learners for recognition. Constructive learning theories include inquiry-based learning theory also. In inquiry-based learning theory, the goal is holistic and enhanced understanding of subject matter reached by solving problems, carrying out projects and experiment. Cognitive and constructive principles, a student processing methods and her prior knowledge and experience are both considered important. Inquiry-based learning theory emphasizes metacognitive process, the mental methods a student develops as she learns the art of learning itself. A teacher using an interdisciplinary approach to a subject that pulls together related art, reading in history and scientific explanation around a related theme is applying inquiry-based learning. Jerome Bruner's discovery-based learning theory. According to Bruner, learner discovers learning from his own curiosity, discovery from his experiments and environment. His theory explained how the subject matter can be learned practically and inquiry-based learning method. Here, learning is flexible, exploratory and fully independent to the learners. It is the basis for self-learning and constructivism concept. This theory stressed 3 points should be taken into account in the teaching learning process. Nature and ability of the learner, the structure of knowledge, nature of knowledge acquisition process. Bruner, in discovery learning, he feels the student is placed in problem-solving situation where they are required to draw on past experience and existing knowledge to discover the facts, relationship and new information. Students are more likely to retain knowledge attained by engaging the real world and contextualized problem solving than by traditional transmission methods. Models that are based upon discovery learning model include guided discovery, problem-based learning, stimulation-based learning, case-based learning, and incidental learning. Piaget's cognitive development theory or conception of equalization is another important constructive learning theory in the process of learning. Piaget proposed that children progress through a sequence of 4 stages, assumed to reflect qualitative differences in child's cognitive abilities, limited by the logical structures in different developmental stages. Learners cannot be taught by key cognitive tasks if they have not reached a particular stage of development. He later expanded this theory to explain how new information is shaped to fit with the learner's existing knowledge, and existing knowledge is itself modified to accommodate the new information. Piaget gives three major concepts in this cognition process. They include assimilation, accommodation, and equilibration. Assimilation. It occurs when the learners perceive new objects or events in terms of existing schemes or operations. This information is compared with existing cognitive structures. Accommodation has occurred when existing schemas or operations must be modified to account for a new experience. Equilibration is the master development process encompassing both assimilation and accommodation. Anomalies of experience creates a state of disequilibrium which can be only resolved when a more adaptive, more sophisticated modes of thought is adopted. Education implications of constructual learning theory. This focuses on the process of children's thinking, not just its products. Teachers should recognize the crucial role of the children's self-initiated and active involvement in learning activities. A deep emphasis on practice aimed at children becoming adult-like in their thinking. Acceptance of individual difference in the development process is effective for teaching learning process. Teachers should less emphasis in the place on direct teaching skills but more on learning in a meaningful learning way. Examples that offer a wide array of such opportunities, technology can be used for teaching learning process. Teachers should use concrete props and visual aids wherever possible. Make instruction relatively short using action as well as words. Don't expect the students to constantly see the world from someone else's point of view. Be sensitive to the possibility that students may have different meanings for same word or different words for the same meaning. Students may also expect everyone to understand the words they have invented. Give children a great deal of hands-on experience with the skills that serve as a building block for more complex skills like reading comprehension. Provide a wide range of experience in order to build a foundation for concept learning and languages. Teachers should offer more humanism cares for students and create a favorable teaching environment for students. It emphasizes on the initiative and interaction in teaching. Students should focus on exploration learning and cooperative learning based on previous experience and experience by means of interactive action. By this way, students can improve their cognitive ability continuously. Teacher can help students form the positive technique, the affection, the attitude, and the habit in learning. All these innovative ideas constitute the complete constructivism teaching theory system, which contribute a lot to modern teaching theory. Teachers should emphasize on cooperation and communication and train students' cooperative consciousness. Students may consult the following reference for further studies. Thank you.